So one of the things that happens to people with type 2 diabetes or people with prediabetes or borderline diabetes is a long time before developing the condition, they develop a thing called insulin resistance. If you have an interest in diabetes and you want to keep up to date, then subscribe, share, comment, and like this page. I want to explain a little bit about how insulin resistance works and why it occurs, because I think there's a few important aspects that are worth knowing about. So with everything with diabetes, we really start with food. If that food is excessive to our current needs, we'll break it down and we'll store it inside a fat cell. And the way that we get particularly carbohydrates into fat cell is there is a lock on the surface of a cell called the insulin receptor. So when insulin as a lock binds to insulin, which is like a key, the two bind together and that actually opens a channel that allows food to get into the cell. Now, if we eat excessive amounts of food, then what will typically happen is that fat cell will increase in size. And if we continue to eat excessive amounts of food, then that fat cell will get bigger and bigger and bigger. And eventually we'll get to the point that even if the fat cell wants to just keep on growing, it's constrained by its physical size. It can't just get bigger. And at that point, the fat cell's in trouble because it has to find a way to prevent excessive amounts of energy, particularly in the form of glucose and carbohydrate, from getting into the fat cell. And the way that's occurring is it changes the shape of the lock and you create this process of insulin resistance. Your fat cells become resistant to the effect of insulin, so you produce a large amount of insulin just to try to open that lock. Now, over time, what happens is the pancreas produces extra insulin and then eventually it can't continue to produce the high amounts of insulin that it needs and the pancreas starts to fail, and specifically, the pancreatic insulin production starts to fail and the blood sugars rise. But can insulin resistance be changed? Well, the answer is, if you lose weight and you shrink your fat cell and you continue to shrink the fat cell, then eventually what will happen is the lock will go back to normal and the insulin will be able to fit nicely. And so when people talk about reversing diabetes, they're really talking about sustained weight reduction that leads to improvement of the shape of the lock. Now, it may be that the pancreatic function, by the time a person decides that they really want to deal with their diabetes, is so diminished that they're not going to be able to produce enough insulin, even with a well-working lock. But nonetheless, if you can reduce insulin resistance, there really is quite a profound improvement in glucose levels that a person can expect. And the earlier that you deal with insulin resistance, the better. If you found this video helpful, then please subscribe to the channel so that I can keep you up to date as all the new videos come online.